Every week in homes across America, food is being tossed in the trash because it's either gone bad or spoiled. Consumer correspondent Susan Copen is here this morning to talk about the best ways to keep your food fresher longer and save some money in the process. Good morning.
Good morning.
So first, let's give everybody some perspective. How much food are we wasting every year?
The average American family is throwing out 500 pounds of food, and that equals $1,200 a year that they're just throwing in the trash can.
And that's because they don't know these tips that you got from experts at all these different industries, the meat, the produce, and the dairy.
Right.
Let's start with meat. The freezer is your friend.
Right. So if we want to talk about things you should never freeze, canned foods and eggs in the shell. Never freeze those products. But when it comes to meat, you have your steak, your chicken. Perfectly fine to freeze these right in the package that you bought, you know, from the store.
But look what it looks like. Look at all that freezer burn.
Well, freezer burn will not ruin the meat. It'll just make it dry in spots.
Oh.
But the better way to go is to put the meat, individually wrap it in foil, put it in a freezer bag, and then put it in the freezer.
I'm very surprised because when I wrap it in foil, I have so much trouble getting the foil off. But that's what they suggested.
That's what they suggest. And steak, 4 to 12 months in the freezer for the best flavor. Chicken, 9 months. You can also freeze deli meat for 3 months.
Whoa.
So your favorite cold cut goes on sale, stock up, freeze some of it.
So I see what you did is very, very smart, because I never remember when I froze it. You wrote the date.
You put the date. And you can freeze meat indefinitely, but it's just a matter of flavor. You should use it within a few months.
What about bread? Can you freeze bread?
You can freeze bread in its original package, 2 weeks. It should be fine. It should not go stale.
You can freeze it for 2 weeks.
Yeah, in its original package.
But how long is it good when you buy it?
When you buy it, you should keep it on the counter, I learned, not in the fridge. The fridge will induce staleness.
Oh, I always keep it
in the
fridge. I'm learning a lot already. Let's move to produce. What are these examples of?
Berries, mushrooms, leafy greens will go bad faster than other things like apples, citrus, and potatoes. And it's also important where you keep things. Apples should be stored
in the fridge.
In the fridge.
Okay.
You're right, in the fridge, okay? Potatoes and tomatoes store on the counter.
Mm, I've been doing that wrong.
Yeah, me too.
So apples in the fridge, potatoes and tomatoes
on the counter.
They will stay fresh longer.
Right. And asparagus, you buy it, cut off the bottoms, put it in water, store it in the fridge.
Has anybody on earth ever heard of that tip?
No.
Look at
this. I mean, when I buy it in the store, it's like that. In my store where I shop,
really?
They have it in water, so it makes sense if I bring it home. That's the way I should store
cut
it.
Cut off
as
the
well.
Bottom like you do with your fresh flowers. Put it in water and then
and
put it in the fridge.
Yeah, okay.
What about
and then
cut up
your
fruit?
Fresh fruit, it can go brown, so you take some lemon juice, orange juice, just sprinkle it on top, and it'll keep it from browning.
You want to start with milk?
We can start with
All
milk,
right. How
sure.
How do you keep milk fresher longer?
Milk should be stored in the back of the fridge, not in the door. It'll be colder in the back. The flavor will last longer. Also, if you buy a container that's non-translucent, your milk will last longer. The flavor will be there longer.
Here's what I've noticed. Sometimes it's not even close to the date of expiration, but it already smells funny to me, so I toss it.
So you toss it. I mean, it's better to be safe than sorry for any of these products we're talking about. If you're not sure, toss it out.
Okay.
But these are some of the great tips that we learned.
Let's get to cheese.
So with cheeses, the way you store your cheese in a baggie wrapped in wax paper and actually use that drawer where you're supposed to put your cold cuts and your cheeses. If you have hard cheeses like Parmesan or cheddar and you see mold, you can cut the mold off and still eat the other part of the cheese.
Nasty, really?
Yes. But if you see mold in stuff like cottage cheese or cream cheese, if it's a soft cheese, toss it right away. It's easy to spread.
So mold, not a problem with hard, but with soft, it's got to go.
Exactly.
All right, yogurt.
And then yogurt should be good a week after its use-by date.
Oh.
Yeah.
Learned a lot, Susan. Thank you so
much.
All right.
A lot happens early on The Early Show, weekday mornings on CBS.